I don't wanna go there. We should never go there. Why you wanna go there? I guess I gotta go there. You're hearing rumors about me and you can't stomach the thought. So please, so please don't judge me. I won't judge you.
Islam, everyone, and welcome to the United States of America Republic in Continental Congress Assembled Government Cabinet Meeting for Sunday, November 20th, 2016. If this is Making History with our President, C. Cannon Bay, and I am your moderator and Speaker of the House, Sister Kolona Sharon Green Eel. Please silence your phones for us when you're not speaking. You can press mute, press star 6 to mute and to unmute. Our meeting is being recorded, audio and video. Let me go ahead and yield the floor to our Secretary of State, Ross Woody Bay Jr., for the reading of our preamble and constitution, as well as our rules for our etiquette in this call.
Islam, and thank you, Speaker of the House, Sister Green L. Islam, brothers and sisters, and welcome to another important conference cabinet meeting of USAR members. Right now, today, you're going to be making history. This is our third wave of laws that we're passing, and these laws are very relevant and pertinent to protecting our people and our nation state. And it's very imperative that folks make these cabinet meetings when we're passing legislation for our citizens. And so we have to make sure that we are very diligent in being here to make history and to make sure that our government is running at top-notch efficiency. So having said that, I want to also say to you, in order for us to move forward on anything and everything that we're trying to do according to what our prophet brought us, then we must, brothers and sisters, excuse me for a second. Yes, I have both of them coming in at the same time, so I'm going to have to hold up just a second. Excuse me, I didn't mean to interfere. What I'm going to say is that we have rules that we go by, and those rules are based upon parliamentary procedures. And because we are Moors, we are the ones that brought this forth on being able to communicate with our brothers and sisters, and as well as other statesmen of other nations. And the reason why we have to have these rules is so that we are able to communicate and get across what we want done to another nation, as well as to our nation and to our cabinet members, so that they're aware of the laws, and also so that our citizens are aware of the laws, so that they're protected under the veil of their nation, having a flag and a landmass and all the things that encompass that a nation has. So this is the reason why we have to go by parliamentary procedures. It allows us to move smoothly through conferences and meetings. If anyone is interested in those, there's a pamphlet that you can get called Parliamentary Procedures for Robert's Rules online. You can get it under the Moore Science Temple of America. You start reading that pamphlet is very small read. And once you get done reading that, you'll have an understanding of how you're supposed to conduct yourself online when we're talking and communicating with each other and other folks. At this time, as I always do before our cabinet meeting, I'm going to read our preamble for we, the Moorish people of the United States of America Republic. Stand by. We, the people of the United States of America Republic, with profound reverence for the supreme ruler of the universe, in order to form a more independent and perfect government, establish love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, ensure tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America Republic as the law of the land. We, the people of the Morris American Society, pledge our lives and property to each other, to gain equal footing in the affairs of men and for other purposes in order to establish justice, promote the health, safety, and welfare, secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do by our representatives in convention ordain and establish the following Constitution, Republic form of government, and mutually agree with each other to form ourselves into a free and independent state by the name of the United States of America Republic, and we do hereby ratify the boundaries assigned to such state by the Act of Redemption at the Pan American Conference in 1928. The aforesaid, which are as follows, to wit, extends from Northeast and Southwest Africa across the Great Atlantis, even unto the present North, South, and Central America, and also into Mexico and the Atlantic Islands, a maxim, Turtle Island, Frog Island. The fate of the unborn millions will now depend, under the Creator of the universe, on the conduct of this sovereign nation state of Morris American nationals and citizens. Let us therefore animate and encourage each other and show the whole world that we, as Morris American nationals and citizens, are contending for liberty as Moors on ground superior to any nation on earth. We now renew our covenant with our Creator. Islam, Islam, and Islam again. And at this time, I'm going to yield the floor back to the sister moderator, Sister Green L., and I yield the floor back to her at this time. Islam.
Islam, and thank you, Secretary of State Rasuli Bey. We are continuing the work of our prophet, Nobuhr Ali. And at this point, we would like to go ahead and welcome three new members to our government cabinet. Galen Carson, who is our lieutenant governor in Ohio. Welcome, Brother Galen Carson. And I apologize for not having your last name, Bay, on there. Timothy Jackson Eel, our lieutenant governor for Georgia. Welcome, Brother Timothy. We definitely look forward to your efforts. As well as Brother Rich Wilson Bay, our lieutenant governor for Virginia. Welcome, Brother Rich. You've already contributed to this government, Islam, and thank you. We're now going to go through our roll call for our USIAR government cabinet members, so feel free to say Islam, present, or whatever moves you to notify us that you're here. President Cannon Bay. Oh, did he try calling back in?
He tried to call me.
Oh.
I couldn't see.
One moment, please, everyone. Islam, my apologies, everyone. Is Cannon Bay here on the line with someone else? Okay, we're going to try and reach him. We know that he tried calling in. Secretary of State Ross Woody Jr. Bay?
Present.
Islam. Here's Cannon Bay. Islam, President Cannon Bay, we were just taking attendance. My apology for not answering your call. And I was just calling your name, President Cannon Bay.
President Cannon Bay, Islam, present.
Islam, thank you. Attorney General Charles Bay?
Present.
Islam. Treasurer Kimberly Ware Bay? She tried calling in also.
No.
Okay, she'll be here in a moment. The governor of North Carolina, Nasir Ma'il.
Islam, present family.
Islam. Governor of Ohio, Terry King Bay. Governor of Virginia, Darnell Brown Bay.
Islam.
One of our senators for Illinois, Sadiq Bey, is going to be moving into a vicegerent position, so he may not be on this call. Also, we have Senator from Georgia, Ronnell Gray Bey.
Present.
Islam, brother. Our governor of Missouri, Floyd Harris Bey, is out today, but he does he did provide his answers or votes for us. Our Senator of Michigan, George Bonbay. Our Senator of Colorado, Kukuyan Il.
Present.
Thank you, Kukuyan. Our Senator of North Carolina, Hope Ma'il.
Islam.
Our representative for California, Demetric Masonia, won't be with us today. Our representative for Colorado, Sister Ajoa Nash Bay.
Present. Islam. Peace and love.
And Sister, how should I say your name? Ajoa Nash Connor Bay?
Or just Ajoa Bay, sis.
All right. Thank you. Our Chief Justice, Romulus Dorsey Eel. Brother Romulus, are you still there? I heard you earlier. Public Minister, Lynth Ann Bashful Eel.
Present.
Islam, sister. Our Public Minister, Maurice Reynolds Bay.
Present.
Islam. Our Vicegerent in Michigan, Damon Lewis Eel. He may be at work and not able to speak, so we'll come back to him. Our governor of California, G. Ruler Eel.
Islam.
Our vicegerent commissioner, Leslie Atkins Eel. Our governor of Georgia, Mandel Williams Eel. Okay. Is there anyone on the call besides the new people that I may have missed?
Islam,
who did I miss?
This is Louis L. Excuse my tardiness.
Oh. No problem. Thank you. I was just calling your name a couple of names ago. All right. You're our vice chair in Michigan. Islam,
Umar Bey, public minister.
Oh, yes, brother. Since you're new, that's okay. We announced you earlier, so yes, we know that you are definitely here. And thank you for being part of USAR.
Wow.
All right. And as we know, our presidential priorities are the passing of our public laws and our resolutions, and then we try effortlessly to get those laws posted the next day. So I do another once-over in proofing them, and then they are posted on the United States Republic.info website. So today we're going to be voting on the legislation for the following laws. We have the specialized land courts, the adopting of the UCC, our notarial laws, and the citizenship and expatriation laws. So let's go to our first law. And first of all, let me just bring President Canabay to the floor in case he has anything that he would like to say before we get to the reading and voting on the laws. Islam, Brother Canabay, you have the floor. Brother Canabay, are you there? You can't unmute. Okay. Well, we're going to go ahead and get to the reading of our laws, and then he will chime in if there's anything that needs to be that needs to be said to us. All righty. So we're going to start with public law number 011-01. The law here is to establish laws adopting a specialized land court. Does anyone have any questions before we get started or comments? And we were looking for any typographical errors, any paragraph, grammatical errors that didn't make sense to you. You can always feel free to make those corrections and submit them in this vote so that we can have the amendments done to this as soon as possible for posting. So we're going to go ahead into the public law 011-01 to establish laws adopting a specialized land court. Pursuant to the United States of America Republic Constitution Amendment 19, Section 2, Clause 2, wherein it states, the United States of America Republic shall make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying into execution the foregoing powers and all other powers vested by this Constitution and the government of the United States of America Republic, or any department or officer thereof, there shall hereby be designated a specialized land court provisions to serve this purpose. This amendment shall go into immediate force. It's introduced as Senate Joint Resolution 01, and we shall know of our co-sponsors for this, as well as House Joint Resolution 01. There was a request delivered before the Continental Congress today to honor and therefore establish these laws for the specialized land court. We will see if this law suffers no amendments, exclusions, or demands that it becomes law. This is the first Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic publicly declaring 2015 the National Year of the United States of America Republic. The document known as Public Law 011-01 will be signed today and passed into law if it suffers no exclusions, amendments, that it becomes law. And we shall have our signatories who are on the line here as attendees. This public law, joint resolution, authorizing and requesting the President to adopt a specialized land court granted by the National Constitution of the United States of America Republic, hereinafter referred to as USAR, which supports the birthright inheritance of Moorish nationals, we the Moorish American people, to the vast estate express trust, and the application of laws based on rules of evidence. This involves issuing court decrees and providing instructions upon the USAR recorder of deeds registrar who will record the court's judgment for all property conveyed into the vast estate express trust. Desiring to promote social and economic well-being while contributing to the national development and to provide a secure, stable, and trustworthy record of land ownership and recorded interest, recognizing that an act concerning land titles approved May 1897, the Registered Title Torrens Act, 765 ILCS 35/0.01 et sec, hereinafter Torrens, a system by which tracts of land are registered and that a state's court special land court is vital in this registration effort. Deciding through its legislation that the state court will preside over complaints, petitions, and applications, conduct judgments, notices, and decrees on behalf of lawfully incorporated and chartered societies, national/citizens of USAR, who seek or have conveyed property into the aforementioned trust. Recognizing various states in the late 19th century uniformly adopted the Torrens Registration Act, but with conflicting provisions of state constitutions, and that this act is not a special law regulating practice in courts of justice, in contravention of former Illinois Constitution 1870, Article 4, Section 22, and see now Illinois Constitution 1970, Article 4, Section 13, as this act is not one relating to practice in courts of record but rules of evidence. Recognizing the need to issue decrees of registration and register documents or any other land transactions for the benefit of land owners, expressing that we, the Moorish American people, are the true inheritance of the Americas by birthright of their forefathers/mothers and indicated by the evidence of the vast estate express trust number recorded in Cook County Recorder of Deeds, Chicago, Illinois, on August 1st, 1928, at 2:52 p.m., and surviving literature in form of an express will bequeathed to said inheritance by their guardian prophet, Noble Prophet Jewali, requiring a judicial system by which lawfully incorporated and chartered societies national / citizens of USAR will register and convey land safely into the VAS Estate Express Trust. Understanding that the Torrens Act controls essentially all dealings with registered lands, and there is no provision of this act concerning land titles which prescribes any different registration procedures. Desiring to provide a secure, stable, and trustworthy record of land ownership and recorded interest, realizing that through the state and its statutes, its property has been managed and administered for those national / citizens, desiring to have full compliance involving our court decree, our state and instruction upon the record of deeds, recorder of deeds / registrar to record its judgment, whereas the United States of America Republic, being a perpetual corporation, is an autonomous state government lawfully incorporated and chartered for the benefit and protection of we, the Moorish American people, by its declaration, national constitution and bylaws, and aforementioned articles. Whereas, this nation now faces great challenges that will test this nation as it has never been tested before, and whereas that renewing our knowledge of law, divine and national, and having faith in our universal creator, through the holy scriptures of the Quran of the Moorish Science of America, the Holy Bible and the great Quran of Muhammad, as we honor all the divine prophets, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius, therefore, the laws and constitution of the United States of America Republic and knowledge of the aforementioned holy scriptures can only strengthen our nation. I, President Christopher H. Cannon Bay, therefore establish with the consent of the Continental Congress the provisions as the laws of the United States of America Republic. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic and Continental Congress assembled that the President is authorized and requested to designate the administration of said laws. So now we shall take it to a vote. And I am going to use, first of all, our attendance record. President Cannon Bay, how do you vote on this law? President Cannon Bay, are you there? Okay, we shall come back to President Cannon Bay. Secretary of State Ross Woody Jr. Bay?
Yay.
Islam President Cannon Bay, yay.
All right, Islam President.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Attorney General Charles Bay?
Yes.
Islam. Treasurer Kimberly Ware Bay?
Go ahead and say.
Gee, I didn't hear anything.
Yeah, make them.
Okay, Sister Kim, we'll come back to you. Our Governor of North Carolina, Nasir Ma'at Eel.
Yay.
Islam. Governor of Virginia, Darnell Brown Bay.
Yay.
Thank you. Senator of Georgia, Ronnell Gray Bay.
Yay.
Thank you. Governor of Missouri, Floyd Harris Bay has given his yay. Our Senator of Michigan, George Bond Bay, did you make it to the call? All right. Our Senator of Colorado, Kakuyan Eel.
I say yay.
Thank you. Our Senator of North Carolina, Hoke Ma'at Eel.
Yay.
Thank you. Our Representative in California, Demetri Mason Eel. Okay, let me go ahead and. All right. Sister Ajoa Bay, our Representative in Colorado.
Yay.
Thank you. Our Chief Justice in Illinois, Romulus Dorothy Eel.
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our public minister in Missouri, Linda Ann Batchelor-Eel.
Islam, I vote yay with a provision, a correction of the word birthright to be corrected within the document.
Okay. Islam, and with that correction, do you vote yay or nay?
I vote yay with the correction.
Thank you, dear. Our public minister, Maurice Reynolds Bay.
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our vice gerent in Michigan, Damon Lewis Eel.
Yay.
Thank you. Our governor in California, G. Riller Eel.
Yay.
Thank you. Leslie Atkins Eel, did you make it to the call? And our governor of Georgia, Mandel Williams Eel, did he make it to the call? All right. Okay, is there anyone that I missed that's not new? We know that the new people didn't get a chance to have the laws in time.
Islam, Sister Kalana, I didn't get a chance to vote.
Oh, yes, Sister Kim, I'm sorry. We couldn't hear you earlier. Well, how do you vote on this law?
I vote yay.
I have no information.
Okay, I think I heard Sister Kim say yay, but we need a clear yay. Can you say that once more, Sister? You were interrupted.
Yay.
Okay, thank you. And who is that that mentioned something?
Noble Abu El.
Oh, Islam. Noble Amunia, thank you for joining us. Okay, and let me just go ahead and put you down for this. Have you had a chance to go through the laws as well?
No, I didn't get them. I didn't get a chance to go through them.
All right. Okay, then we're going to not have you vote on these laws since you didn't get a chance to, I'm not sure if it was checking your email. But you did give me a new email today, so you'll be able to receive all of the laws.
Okay.
All right. So this law has passed unanimously as resolution, excuse me, Public Law 011, Resolution 01. And this is our law for a specialized, adopting, excuse me, a specialized land court. Islam.
Islam, I have one question.
Islam.
I thought I saw an ILCS in there.
Oh. Let's see.
Was that just making mention to the ILCS?
Yes, it was, because it was the Torrens Act. This here?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So
go ahead, President.
So are you saying we're adopting from the Illinois 76 ILC that number in sequence, we're adopting from that to our own law?
Yes.
Okay. That's all I want to know.
All right. Thank you. Okay, any other comments or questions from anyone else before we close on this particular law to adopt the specialized land court?
Islam Kalona, this is Rafael Vasquez, EL.
Islam, Brother Rafael. How are you?
Yeah, just to show you that I'm also present also, okay?
Say that once more, please.
I said just to confirm that I am present in this meeting.
Great. All right, good to hear you. And let me go ahead and put you down here for our foreign minister. And then how do you vote on this law that was read, Brother Rafael Vasquez?
I vote yay.
Okay.
Islam.
Islam.
Two Islams on the floor. The first one, please, what is that?
Brother Sadiq.
Islam, Brother Sadiq, how are you?
I'm okay. How are you doing?
Good. We know that you were going to take a position of vicegerent. So are you going to stay in the senator position until that comes into fruition?
I did nail off the form that I was switching out of the Senate. So, I guess I can't stay in the Senate until you all get the information from me, and then we go from there. If that's feasible, for now.
I think so. All right. So your vote on this law today that was read as Public Law 011-01.
It's yay. I've seen it.
Perfect. Okay, thank you. And then there was another Islam on the floor.
That's Brother Rich.
Islam, Brother Rich. Did you have a chance to go through the law?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. I did have a chance to go through them. I can vote it.
Certainly. That would be great. Okay. Since I didn't have... Excuse me, I didn't know if I had a chance to send them out. And with you and Umar and Brother Galen being new, there was no expectation that you would vote. But if you did have a chance to read through them and you want to vote for them, you certainly are welcome to do so as you're part of Congress.
Okay, yes, if I would vote, yeah.
All right, Lieutenant Governor of Virginia, Rich Wilson. It's ill, right? Not day?
It's day.
Day. All right. And so you are voting yay on Public Law 011-1 for the adoption of Specialized Land Corps.
Yes, that's correct.
Thank you very much. All right. So we have a unanimous vote, continued unanimous vote for this law. So that has been passed into law. Islam?
Yes, this is Brother G. Carson Bay.
And, Islam, Brother Galen.
Hello, Islam. Hey, I didn't get the link as far as to view the laws, but still yet. Now, this law is what again?
What we'll do is go ahead and send them out. You'll see them actually on the website as passed. Since you didn't have a chance to read through them, there was no expectation that you would vote on them since you're new, you and Brother Umar. Brother Rich has been here for a moment, so he did receive them. So you will be able to see them, and then we'll send out another set of laws to vote on for the next cabinet meeting.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
They can't, Islam, point answer, they can't still place a vote after they read it before posting time, right?
Yes. If they, I would have to send them out and make sure that they got them today. Brother Umar and Brother Galen and Brother Amun. So,
okay. I'm looking at
these. Okay.
I could still vote forward as far as the ones that are being pronounced right now.
That would make sense to me, Brother Cannon Bay. They're being read verbally, and so if they're listening...
Wouldn't that be also before midnight?
Can they vote now, today, right now, Cannon Bay?
They can if they wish.
Thank you.
Okay.
So let me just say this. Brother Umar, you heard the law read. Do you vote yay or nay on that Public Law 011-01 for the adoption of Specialized Land Court?
Islam, I vote yay.
Thank you. So let me put down, you are our Lieutenant Governor, Public Minister, and your full name is William Salter Eel. Galen Carson is our Lieutenant Governor for Ohio. All right, perfect. Okay. G. Riller Eel, I see your text, so I understand that you need to leave the meeting and that you have extended your vote for all the laws as yay. And thank you very much for your notification, Islam.
You're welcome. Peace and love, more.
All right. Peace and love.
Morning, Islam.
Yes, Brother Umar? Excuse me.
No.
Brother Amun?
Yes, President. I was wondering, once I read the, I've already read the law on the website, and I want to render my vote as yes.
All right. Let me just make sure. I need to make one adjustment. Hold on one moment. Noble Lamoon, you know, can you give your full name? I'm so used to calling you by your spiritual name. Brother Amun, can you give your full name? I have your spiritual name only. Can you just tell the people?
Okay. You want my other name?
Your full name that you were born with the eel or bay on the end.
Okay. Clayton Ronald Williamson L.
Clayton.
Ronald.
Ronald Henderson L. Thank you. My apologies. I know I have it. I just couldn't remember. And so you're voting as one of our senators in Illinois, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for your vote. You're voting yay on this law?
Yeah.
All right. Now I will include you in the rest of the vote. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Islam, I would like to place my vote also. This is G. Carson Bay.
Okay. I thought I got your vote, brother, but I apologize if I didn't.
Oh, okay. Yeah. For the specialized land court, it is? Yes, I would definitely vote yay for that.
All right, thank you. Is there anyone else on the line that I missed? Okay. Well, thank you very much. Let's go ahead and move to the second law. I may be going out of order in sequence, forgive me, but this is Public Law 11, let's go in order. 112-01. To establish laws for Notarial Act. Pursuant to the United States of America Republic Constitution Amendment 19, Section 2, Clause 2, wherein it states the United States of America Republic shall make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying into existence, for carrying into execution the foregoing powers and all other powers vested by this Constitution in the government of the United States of America Republic, or any department or officer thereof, there shall hereby be designated Notarial Acts provisions to serve this purpose. This amendment shall go into immediate force. It is introduced as Senate Joint Resolution 01 of the 112 section, and we shall see the co-sponsors that have sponsored this bill, and House Joint Resolution 01. This request is delivered before the Continental Congress to honor and therefore establish laws for Notarial Acts. We shall see if this resolution shall suffer any amendments, exclusions, or demands that it becomes law. And this is the first Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic, and we publicly declare 2015 the National Year of the United States of America Republic. And this document shall be known as Public Law 112-01. And it shall be signed into law today if it is passed. It's authorizing and requesting the President to adopt notarial laws for the United States of America Republic under the direction and auspice of the Secretary of State, who is responsible for reviewing and approving course curriculum and issuing certificates of approval to notarial officer applicants, appointing and commissioning qualified persons as notarial officers for seven-year terms, certifying to the authenticity of notarial officers and public officials' signatures, i.e., recorder of deeds, vital records, attorney general, court services, business and marriage licenses, directors, issuing permits to authorize seal manufacturers to produce notarial officer seals, maintaining and distributing a list of all authorized seal manufacturers to newly commissioned notarial officers, investigating violations of notarial law and taking appropriate administrative or criminal disciplinary actions, ensuring that each notarial officer keeps a journal of the notarial acts. Whereas the United States of America Republic, USAR, being a perpetual corporation, is an autonomous state government lawfully incorporated and chartered for the benefit and protection of we, the Moorish American people, by its declaration, national constitution and bylaws, and articles of incorporation. Whereas the history of our nation clearly illustrates the value of a nation to be able to create and pass its own laws, are beneficial to a society to enforce the laws of the nation, this is not to remove or change the Moorish American people from voluntarily applying and extending the learning, teachings, and truths of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Sign Temple of America in the lives of individuals, families, or in their society as a nation of people. Whereas this nation now faces great challenges that will test this nation as it has never been tested before, and whereas that renewing our knowledge of law, divine and national, and having faith in our universal creator through holy scriptures of the Quran, of the Moorish Science Temple of America, the Holy Bible, and the great Quran of Muhammad, as we honor all the divine prophets, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius, therefore, the laws and constitution of the United States of America Republic, and I will change that to constitution and laws, with the constitution being first, and knowledge of the aforementioned holy scriptures can only strengthen our nation. President Christopher H. Cannon Bay, therefore, establishes with the consent of this Continental Congress the provisions of the laws of the United States of America Republic. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic in Continental Congress assembled that the President is authorized and requested to designate the administration of said laws. And this legislative history is Public Law 112, Resolution 01. We shall go to the members now and find out what their votes will be for this law, for Notarial Act. President Cannon Bay, how do you vote on this law?
President Cannon Bay, I vote yay. And you missed the L on law when you made that correction.
Thank you. All right. So that's our yay from President Cannon Bay. Our Secretary of State, Ross Woody, Jr. Bay, how do you vote?
Madam Speaker, I will give a vote on it after the changes that I see on page 2 of 7 for 7-year terms is changed to 4 years on page 2 of 7.
So you would like that amended and you motion for that change to go from 7 years to 4-year terms on the appointing and commissioning of qualified persons in and, the notarial office.
Yes, that is correct. And the reason for that is because of the changing laws that notarials have to go through. And so my proposal is to change it from 7-year to 4-year. Also, that change.
Let's get a, if that's going to be a change, let's get a, that's a motion. And then we need someone else to second it. I second that emotion, that motion.
Islam?
Yes, Islam. Brother Kakuya?
Yes. I don't agree in shortening that. I think it should be more than 7 years, not just 7. And
okay, we'll come back. We'll come to you in one. Let's just finish up with Secretary. All right. Thank you.
All right.
Now. Let me go ahead and let you finish.
The reason why I was saying that the shortening needed to be done is because of the notarial laws that have to be, you know, a person that has that terms attached to them, that they have the authority to sign documents and notarize documents from our nation state, needs to be constantly updated. So that's why I was saying if you went for the longer term of 7 years, that's not a guarantee that that individual or individuals are going to get updated training. As with it's pointed out in our bullet points under reviewing and approving course curriculum and issuing certificates of approval to the notarial officer applicants, keywords reviewing and approving course curriculum. We don't know if they're going to continually keep getting that if they just say, go for 7 years. If you go to a longer period of time, if you go to a shorter period of time, that requires them to re-qualify each time to make sure that our documents are in order as it pertains to them coming from our nation state and representing our nation state as the seal of our state, giving the seal of approval from the authority within our government. So that's why I have proposed it for that change to happen. And if we do motion that change to happen, it would be on page 2 of 7 as well as on page 5 of 7. I yield back to the Madam Speaker.
Would it be possible that if we kept the 7-year term, that we would actually make the notary have to re-educate themselves? There's curriculum that they would have to learn every time something new came out. These are our laws. We can say the notary can go for as long as possible that's necessary. But if there's changes, it's up to the Secretary of State to make sure that these notaries are re-educated throughout their commission period.
Madam Speaker, I'm in agreement with that. If we have that curriculum within as a requirement on that 7-year period. If not, if we don't have a requirement and they're in 7 years and they don't have a requirement for a curriculum training update to make sure they're current from our nation state to make sure that our seals on our paperwork is good, then I vote against. But if it is, then if that curriculum is in there, then we can leave the 7-year period in place. I yield the floor.
Okay. All right. Let me see if that – bring Brother Kakuyan to the floor with regards to that one point, and then we'll come to Sister Lynn and Bashful. Brother
Kakuyan? My understanding, Islam, my understanding is that being updated is part of the job. It's like when I'm in the National Massage Therapy Association, when they update our rules, it's part of my job to do the updated, you know, to keep current with it. So, I mean, why isn't it the case in this situation? If you're a notary, your job is to, you know, inquire monthly as to whether there's any updated, you know, rules, and then you can, you know, you read them. And I mean, it's part of the job. I mean, I don't understand why that's not considered part of the job.
All right. The Secretary of State agrees with you.
I'm in agreement with that, brother, and I do think we should pass your votes and concerns forward.
Okay. Sister Emily, yes, Sister Ajoa Bay?
Yes, this is Sister Ajoa Bay, and I am a notary of America at this point, and they do require that every 2 years we come back in and we receive a just an updating on everything, because no, we're not expected to be able to keep up with every change that they make. So if every 2 years they call us in for a study and for a, you know, recapping of everything, then we're up to par. So I guess I'm saying that to I would agree with the original statement from the Secretary of State, which was every 4 years, just because then that keeps us on target of every 4 years, definitely, whether or not you've been able to keep up with it. Well, by 4 years, you will be required to check in just to make sure you're on top.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Sister Ajoa. We have Sister Linda Ambashful.
Islam, I would like to bring to the floor, and it doesn't have to be, I know that certain things are understood. Is understood based upon our laws, but I would like to see
in addition to the shortened period for the notoria, that there is a caveat, a note of some type to state that as long as they are at in adherence to being a citizen of USAR, that they will be also eligible, not just based upon the fact that they were a notary prior to an expiration date, but that they will fulfill the citizenship requirements as a national, which is stated, but I think it should be referenced just to Title VI in the, I think it's the first part.
Title VI. Is that...
Well, of the notarial, they have the requirements in that I was wanting to add, you know, to be an adherence of Title VI for citizenship.
Oh, that's...
Yeah, to cross-reference.
Oh, yes. Most definitely, they would have to be a citizen
yes.
or national
mm-hmm.
in order to be a notary.
Right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I just wanted to cross-reference.
Gotcha. So, yes, these are all notarial laws and acts for anyone who is a citizen or national. Otherwise, they would be a notary for another entity or state. Mm-hmm.
Everybody with the understanding of that, Madam Secretary?
Is everyone with the understanding that you have to be in USAR in order to be a USAR notary? Yes. I would.
Yes. All the new ones on the line.
Yes.
I just want to make sure that they had an
yes.
understanding of what you were saying.
Okay, yes. We just want to make sure everyone on this call knows that we are voting for USAR laws, and so anything pertaining to any of the laws mentioned are with regards to USAR. So it was just a point made by Secretary of State wanting to make sure everyone knew that. So for these laws for notary, we have a proposed four-year time frame and continuance of the education and the curriculum for people who are notaries to learn the new rules, because they will be given the new rules by our Secretary of State. So do we want to leave it at the seven-year term, or do we want to change it to the four-year term? All those in favor of the seven-year term the way it is, I will come individually and ask you, as I ask you about the yay or nay vote, if you have 4 years or 7 years that you would prefer for this law. Okay. So let me go and go to our people. President Canabe, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Do you vote for the seven-year or the four-year term?
I vote for the seven.
Seven. Thank you.
Yeah. Then I have seven. It's complete. It's not.
It's gone.
Yes, sir.
Secretary of State Ross Woody Jr. Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote for the original, even after I've heard the comments made for 4 years.
4 years.
I can barely hear him.
He stated that he would go for the 4 years. He's voting for that law as yay and four-year term. Our Attorney General Charles Bay, how do you vote for this law?
Yay, and the term is determined by the will of the people, so I support the will of the people. Peace.
All right. Thank you very much. And our Treasurer Kimberly Ware Bay. Is she still on your line?
Is Sister Kim, are you there?
Okay. All right, we'll come back to Sister Kimberly. Our Governor of North Carolina, Nasir Ma'at Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Yay for the original seven.
Seven. Thank you very much. Governor of Ohio, Terry King Bay, I don't think he's made it on this call. Our Governor of Virginia, Darnell Brown Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for four.
All right. Our Senator of Illinois, Sadiq Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay, and I vote for 7 years.
All right, thank you. Our Senator for Georgia, Brother Ronnell Gray Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 4 years.
All right, thank you. Our governor of Missouri is voting for this law, yay, without any of the changes, Floyd Harris Bay, so that's the original 7 years. Our senator of Colorado, Brother Kakuyan Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Islam, I vote yay for 7 years.
Thank you. Our Senator of North Carolina, Hope Ma'atil, how do you vote for this law?
Yay for 7 years.
Okay, thank you. Our representative in Colorado, Sister Joa Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay and for the 4 years.
Okay, thank you. Our Chief Justice, Romulus Dorsey Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 7 years.
Thank you. All right, and our public minister, Linda Ann Bashful Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay, and I vote for the for the 4 years for Represents Foundation and the Four Forces. That was so good.
Thank you, Sister Emily. Our Public Minister Maurice Reynolds Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for the 4 years.
Thank you, brother. Our Vice Chairman in Michigan, Damon Lewis Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Yay, 4 years.
Okay. All right. And our governor of California, G. Wheeler Eel, has given his yay for this for the 7 years. All right. And our foreign minister, Rafael Vasquez Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Yay for 7 years.
Okay. Our lieutenant governor in Virginia, Rich Wilson Bay, how do you vote for this law?
Yay for 4 years.
Thank you. All right. Our public minister in Florida, William Salter Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 4 years.
Thank you. Our lieutenant governor in Ohio, Galen Carson Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 7 years.
All right. Seven, thank you. And our senator in Illinois, Clayton Ronald Henderson Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 7 years.
All right, thank you very much. Sister Kim? Our treasurer, Islam, sister, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay for 7 years.
Okay, thank you very much. Is there anyone that I've missed on that law, of Public Law 112-01 on this Notarial Act? Okay, so we have how many votes for the 7 years? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 for the 7 year term. I vote for the 7 year term. Okay, and then one for the 4 years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes. Oh, Islam, Brother Leslie Atkins, thank you for joining us. Let me just unmute you because there was noise coming from your phone before.
Sister Kalana, this is Sister Charlene on the phone as well.
Islam, I don't know. My apologies.
It's okay.
My apologies. Okay. I'm doing so many things here. I just need to make sure that I put your name down. And you are our senator in Illinois.
Yes.
MCMUL Union, and then we have all right. So our lovely Atkins-Eo, Vice President, excuse me, Vice Gerent Commissioner has voted yay for 4 years. And Sister Shirlene McMullen, our Senator in Illinois, what was your vote?
I vote yay for 4 years.
4 years. Okay. We still have the 7 years as the ruling time frame for that law. So we have just passed our second law today. This is public law number 112-01 to establish laws for notarial acts, passed on this 20th November day, 2016. Islam, everyone, and thank you. All right, our next law is going to be public law number 110-01. To establish laws adopting the Uniform Commercial Code as laws of USAR. Pursuant to the United States of America Republic Constitution Amendment 19, Section 2, Clause 2, where it states the United States of America Republic shall make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying into execution the foregoing powers and all other powers vested by this Constitution in the government of the United States of America Republic or any department or officer thereof, There shall hereby be adopted the Uniform Commercial Code provisions to serve this purpose. This amendment shall go into immediate force. It will be introduced as Resolution 01 of the 110 category with our co-sponsors of the House Joint Resolution 01. And this request is being delivered before the Continental Congress to honor and therefore establish laws to adopt the Uniform Commercial Code as laws of USAR. We shall see the amendments, exclusions, or demands it may suffer to become law. The First Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic publicly declared 2015 the National Year of the United States of America Republic. And this document, known as Public Law 110-01, shall be made into law if signed by all of our signatories in General Congress assembled. And so this joint resolution authorizing and requesting the President to adopt the following articles of the Uniform Commercial Code, Articles 1, 2, 2A, 3, 4, 4A, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of the UCC to become part of the laws of the United States of America Republic for governing commerce within our state and beyond. And whereas the United States of America Republic USAR, being a perpetual corporation, is an autonomous state government lawfully incorporated and chartered for the benefit and protection of we the Moorish American people, by its declaration, national constitution and bylaws and articles of incorporation, deriving all its power from the Constitution of the United States of America Republic and the decrees of registration. Deriving all its power from the Constitution of the United States of America Republic and its judicial. And its judicial branch of government. And that can be a correction if anyone needs to make that correction. Whereas the Moorish American people have made a unique contribution in shaping the United States of America Republic as a distinctive and blessed nation of people and citizens. Whereas the Moorish American people are a people of deeply held religious convictions springing from the Holy Scriptures of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America and the learning, teachings, and truth of the Holy Prophet Noble Drew Ali. The Holy Prophet Noble Drew Ali led his people back to the principles and standards of their ancient forefathers, free national principles and standards. Whereas the principles of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, inspired concepts of civil government that are contained in our Declaration of Independence and Constitution of the United States of America Republic. Whereas the Moorish American people are now in great comprehension that as a nation of people, being nationwide in scope, to achieve peace as well as unity as a single harmonious nation, there must be uniform laws for the nation. The laws and constitution, or as we have normally put into place, the constitution and laws of the United States of America Republic, are the rock on which our republic rests. Whereas the history of our nation clearly illustrates the value of a nation to be able to create and pass its own laws, are beneficial to a society, to enforce the laws of the nation. This is not to remove or change the Moorish American people from voluntarily applying or extending the learning, teachings, and truth of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America in the lives of individuals, families, or in our society as a nation of people. Whereas this nation now faces great challenges that will test this nation as it has never been tested before, and whereas that renewing our knowledge of law, divine and national, and having faith in our universal creator through holy scriptures of the Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America, the Holy Bible, and the great Quran of Muhammad, as we honor all the divine prophets, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius. Therefore, the laws and constitution of the United States of America, Republic, and the knowledge of the aforementioned holy scriptures can only strengthen our nation. President Christopher H. Cannon Bay therefore establishes with the consent of this Continental Congress the provisions as the laws of the United States of America Republic. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic and Continental Congress assembled that the President is authorized and requested to designate the administration of said laws. So let's go to each of the Cabinet members and see their votes for this particular law known as Public Law 110-01. And it is for the adoption of the Uniform Commercial Code as laws of USAR. Islam, first on the floor, President Cannon Bay, how do you vote for this law?
President Cannon Bay, I'll vote yay. And can you scroll back to the one spot where you made the correction at?
Yes, I can. 2-25, what is that?
I want you to... I would like for you to change that, deriving.
Deriving all its power from the Constitution of the United States of America Republic. Yes, I'm ready.
Scroll up just a little. Let me see what's up over there. Hold it. I would like for you to put right there, if you don't mind, all its power from the Creator.
Deriving all its power from the Creator?
Yeah.
All right.
And His people?
And its people?
His people.
His people. Thank you.
As well as the Constitution and laws for the United States of America Republic. On the end, when you put in its judicial branch of government, that's removed it.
Thank you.
Islam.
Islam.
I yield the floor.
And with these proposed changes, President, you are now giving your vote for this law as a yay?
Islam, President Cannon Bay, I vote yay.
Thank you, Islam. Secretary of State Ross Woody Jr. Bay, how do you vote for this law?
Madam Speaker, I'm going to put a question on the floor. On the same page, under Public Law 110-01, clarification on the third paragraph from the bottom, right where it says the Holy Quran of the Morristown Temple of America. For me, I want to make sure that I overstand this, that we're only putting it as the Holy Quran as opposed to the Circle 7 Holy Quran, because down at the bottom we also have it, and I'm being technical with it, because right here where we have the Creator through Holy Scriptures, in the bottom paragraph, we have the Quran of the Morristown Temple of America. So don't we think that they should be uniform?
Yes. Holy Scriptures of the Quran.
So are we going to put it as Circle 7? That's what I'm asking.
No. It was voted that we did not want to use Circle 7.
Okay. But what you do have in one paragraph does have to match the other. If you're saying in the specific paragraph, the Morristown Temple of America.
I just need to know where that other...
Okay, the other one is in the third paragraph from the bottom.
Okay, third from...
The bottom, right under Morris American People.
Where does it start? Whereas, because I've made changes, so it may not be exactly the same.
Okay, right under the third paragraph from the bottom, there it says Morris American People in bold print.
Whereas the Morris American People?
This is not to remove or change the Morris American People. You see that? Now, right under it, it says, of the Holy Quran.
Yes.
Okay. Now, my question for clarity is, are we going to say of the Holy Quran for each one of those as it pertains to the Morristown Temple? See what I'm saying? Of America.
Okay. So the word holy in front of Quran, in the paragraph now that starts with whereas that renewing our now knowledge of law.
Yeah. And
okay.
All I'm saying is they have the uniform. Which are you going to use?
The Holy Scriptures, so we can say, if this is what you're thinking, whereas that renewing our knowledge of law,
divine and national, and having faith in our universal Creator through Holy Scriptures of the Holy Quran.
Right.
So the word holy is being added
here. Anytime you use Morristown Temple of America, the Holy Quran has to be in front of it or behind it, if you're using that word, that phrase.
I use that, I see that as a grammatical error, if you will, of the proper name of the book. So we will go ahead and make it as the Holy Quran. It's not a proposed change, it's just a grammatical correction.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
Anywhere else, Madam Speaker, that it may be in the document.
Islam.
And yay is my vote.
Islam. Thank you very much, Secretary of State. Attorney General Charles Bay.
Yes, and just a brief comment. The phrase Circle 7 is an inappropriate phrase to use to identify the book because it's simply the symbol that appears on the front cover. But the Holy Quran of MST of A or Morristown Temple of America is the appropriate language that should be used to identify. I yield the floor.
Islam, brother, thank you. And your vote, I just want to make sure you said yay, correct?
That is correct. I voted yes.
Thank you, Islam. Our treasurer, Kimberly Ware Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Islam, thank you. All right. Our governor for North Carolina, Nasir Ma'at-Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Islam, I vote yay.
Islam, thank you. Our governor of Virginia, Darnell Brown Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Islam, thank you. Our senator of Illinois, Shirlene McMullen Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Whoops. Leslie Atkins-Eel, our vice chair and commissioner, how do you vote for this law? Let me just make sure I didn't mute you, brother. Uh-oh. I think you have yourself on mute. If you *6, you can *6 your way out of the mute. But if you want to use the chat room like you've been doing it, that's fine, too. Okay, he left the meeting. All right. Let's come back to that, brother. Our Vice Jarrett, Leslie Atkins-Eel. Senator of Illinois, Sadiq Bey, how do you vote for this law?
Oh, yay.
Thank you, brother. A senator for Georgia, Ronnell Gray Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our governor for Missouri, Floyd Harris Bay, has voted yay for this law. Our senator for Colorado, Kakuyan Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our senator for North Carolina, Hope Ma'at-Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our representative of Colorado, Mr. Ajoa Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our Chief Justice Romulus Dorsey Eel in Illinois, how do you vote?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our Public Minister Linda Ann Bashful Eel, how do you vote?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Our Public Minister Maurice Reynolds Bay, how do you? No, I'm sorry. Your title had changed, did it not?
Not yet.
Not yet? Okay. Public Minister Maurice Reynolds Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay, sister.
Thank you. Our vice chair in Michigan, Damon Lewis Eel, how do you vote for this law?
Yay.
I heard a yay. Thank you, brother. All right. Then we have Governor of California, G. Riller Eel, who has voted yay for the rest of the laws. Our Foreign Minister Rafael Vasquez Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Islam, thank you, brother. All right. Our Lieutenant Governor of Virginia, Brother Rich Wilson Bay, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay. However, I would like to bring up one possible correction just for consistency purposes.
You're coming in very faint.
How's it now? Is it better?
No, that's no better. It's still very faint.
Okay, let me see if I can. Testing 1, 2, 3. Any better?
We can hear you enough so that if you vote, it's still very faint, like in, you're far away from the phone, but just go ahead and vote and we should be able to hear you.
I want to vote yay with one possible correction.
With one possible correction? Okay.
Yes. If you go to page 2 of 25.
All right.
I think it was. Okay, the last sentence there.
The last sentence.
Yeah, in the last paragraph.
Last paragraph?
Yep. I think in the other laws where you have, therefore, the laws and Constitution of the United States, I think you have the Constitution and laws of the United States switched around.
Therefore, the laws. Now, the paragraph has changed, so on page 2, it now ends in, whereas that renewing our knowledge. That's the last paragraph.
Correct. So the last sentence of that paragraph.
Therefore, the laws and Constitution of the United States of America Republic?
Yes.
Switch around laws to Constitution.
Yeah. I think in the other laws, you have the Constitution and laws of the United States.
Yeah, that's going to happen to for everything, yes.
Oh, okay.
The Constitution is always first.
Okay.
My apology. Mm-hmm.
Other than that, I vote yay.
All right, brother. Thank you. All right. Public Minister William L. Salter III Eel, Islam, brother, how do you vote for this law?
Islam, I vote yay.
There must be something the matter with mine, because you're sounding just as far away as the other brother.
Hello?
Can you say that for me one more time?
Yay. I vote yay.
Very faint, and I don't know what happened.
Just one, two. Same two.
Brother William Salter, William L. Salter, the third L. Can you can you say that one more time for me?
I vote yay.
That's a little better. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Galen Carson Bay, our Lieutenant Governor of Ohio.
Yes, I vote yay.
Okay, thank you. Our Senator in Illinois, Clayton Ronald Henderson Eel, how do you vote for this law?
I vote yay.
Thank you. Okay. And so this law, public law number 110-0 on the adoption of the Uniform Commercial Code for laws as laws of USAR, is now passed into law on the 20th day of November 2016. Thank you all. Our last law for today is Public Law 116-10 to establish laws for citizenship and expatriation. Pursuant to the United States of America Republic Constitution, Amendment 19, Section 2, Clause 2, wherein it states, the United States of America Republic shall make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying into execution the foregoing powers and all other powers vested by this Constitution in the government of the United States of America Republic, or any department or officer thereof, there shall hereby be designated citizenship and expatriation provisions to serve this purpose. This amendment shall go into immediate force. It is introduced as number 116-01 resolution for the Senate and 01 resolution for the House. Under that 116. And this request is being delivered before the Continental Congress to honor and establish laws for citizenship and expatriation. We shall see if this resolution suffers any amendments, exclusions, or demands to become law. The First Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic publicly declared 2015 the National Year of the United States of America Republic, and this document shall be known as Public Law 116-01, and we shall see if it's signed and passed into law today by the attendees. This law joint resolution is authorizing and requesting the President to enact laws to proclaim and establish laws for the citizenship and expatriation of its citizens and establish its registrar for the Bureau of Vital Statistics as per the Constitution and laws of the United States of America Republic. Desiring to provide laws for our nationals and citizens inland and abroad, whereas the United States of America Republic, being a perpetual corporation, is an autonomous state government, lawfully incorporated and chartered for the benefit and protection of we the Moorish American people, by its declaration, national constitution, and bylaws, and aforementioned articles. Whereas the United States of America Republic's official language is the English language, whereas the Moorish American people have made a unique contribution in shaping the United States of America Republic as a distinctive and blessed nation of people and citizens, whereas the Moorish American people are a people of deeply held religious convictions springing from the Holy Scriptures of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America and the learning, teachings, and truth of the Holy Prophet Noble Dhu Aalin. The Holy Prophet Noble Dhu Aalin led his people back to the principles and standards of their ancient forefathers' free national principles and standards. Whereas the principles of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice inspire concepts of civil government that are contained in our Declaration of Independence and Constitution of the United States of America Republic. Whereas the Moorish American people are now in great comprehension that as a nation of people being nationwide in scope, to achieve peace as well as unity as a single harmonious nation, there must be uniform laws for the nation. The laws and constitution of the United States of America Republic, the constitution and laws of the United States of America Republic are the rock on which our republic rests. Whereas the history of our nation clearly illustrates the value of a nation to be able to create and pass its own laws are beneficial to a society to enforce the laws of the nation,
This is not to remove or change the Moorish American people from voluntarily applying and extending the learning, teachings, and truth of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America in the lives of individuals, families, or in their society as a nation of people. Whereas this nation now faces great challenges that will test this nation as it has never been tested before, and whereas that renewing our knowledge of law, divine and national, and having faith in our universal creator through holy scriptures of the Holy Quran of the Moorish Science Temple of America, the Holy Bible, and the Great Quran of Muhammad, as we honor all the divine prophets, Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and Confucius, therefore, the laws and constitution, and we shall say constitution and laws, of the United States of America Republic, and law and knowledge of the aforementioned holy scriptures can only strengthen our nation. President Christopher H. Cannon Bay, therefore, establishes with the consent of the Continental Congress the provisions as the laws of the United States of America Republic. And now, therefore, be it resolved by the Continental Congress of the United States of America Republic in Continental Congress assembled that the President is authorized and requested to designate the administration of said laws. Now let's go to the floor for a vote by our members on this particular law.
Can I ask a question? Islam.
Islam, Brother Kakuyan.
Why was 2 years decided as the term of the passports?
It was proposed. It wasn't decided. That's what we're doing today. So
okay.
If you have an amendment that you would like to make, yes, you can certainly do that. And then we will bring it to the floor for a second and passing.
Okay.
Yes.
With the American passport, it's 10 years. So I was wondering why it was so short at 2.
Mhm. Islam. All right. So let's go to our floor for the vote.
Right.
President Cannon Bay, how do you vote for this law?
President Cannon Bay, I vote yay.
Yes, and do you have any amendments, President Cannon Bay, that you think should be made, in your opinion?
Islam, not at this time.
Thank you. Islam,
your time is far away.
Excuse me? Who is that?
I'm sorry, Sister Sherlyn Bay. You're kind of sounding like you're distant a little bit.
Can anyone else hear me? And do I sound distant to anyone else?
Right, you're good now.
Okay. And so, Secretary of State Ross Woody Jr. Bay, how do you vote for this law?
Madam Speaker, I, being your Secretary of State, I have to say that I have several amendments to Title VI of Citizenship and Exportation, Chapter 1. And that is the second paragraph under Section 1, Certificates of Nativity. I have a question on the floor to you, Madam, Mr. President. Under Section A, are we going to add age of the woman at 18 of maturity and or the men at 21? Having read that paragraph. And I have several more amendments that I would like to make as well. Well, under Section D,
you're saying that every child being a Moorish American citizen, that's A, correct?
Mm-hmm. It's not a point of entry. It's not. She got to come closer so we can hear what y'all talking about. We just hear her in the background.
Okay. Can you hear me better now?
Yes, we can.
All right, so the proposed change, Brother Ross Winnie Bay, is what?
The proposed amendment is I'm just putting it on the floor. Are we talking 18 years separating the male from the female, female being 18 and the male being 21 for maturity, or are we just going to leave it at 18 as you have in your second sentence of that paragraph, the age of 18 years to record at the most convenient United States Republic consulate. That was just a question.
Okay. That's the child that could be male or female. So once they reach the age, if they're abroad, then once they reach the age of 18, they record at the most convenient consulate their intention to become a resident and remain a citizen of USAR. So that could be a male or female.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, for that clarity. And also down in Section D on page 5 of 7, issue qualified passports to those who had made the declaration of intention. Yes, on this page 5 of 7 on declaration of intention. We're leaving that as is. Become, okay.
Okay, so the...
It was just a question on that. Declaration of intention is the words that we were using for that. Okay.
So those who... Yes, so someone who wants to have a passport, who is abroad, must make their declaration of intention to become citizen of the United States of America Republic. Okay. All right.
Madam Speaker, and to the members of the Cabinet, also I have a question when we're talking about page 6 of 7, Section 2, passports. I see where you have down at the bottom of the paragraph of Section A, Section 2, subsection A, provisional passports for particular journey or occasion and limited in the length of time of their validity to not more than 6 months. My question with this is, are we going to be from USAR issuing provisional passports, or is this a visa on our land when somebody comes for a limited time or period on our soil and in visiting our nation? That's the question I'm putting on the floor for invoking that the visa as opposed to the provisional passport.
Islam, President Cannon Gates. I was thinking they were coming here from another nation, they would have a passport issued by their country. Why would they have our passport?
Right, that's true.
Or a visa at all from us coming into our country. They would need their passport or visa from their own country. They would simply be a visiting guest in this country that would have to go through the requirements of the Secretary of State so you can get allowed to come in the country in the first place. But their passport and their visa from their country would have to go through the scrutiny of the Department of State and our government to determine even the validity of their passport or visa to even enter the country in the first place.
The point of interest.
As long as I get to you.
Mr. President, being that I've traveled quite a bit, this is the reason why I'm asking for clarity here for this, because even though the person comes here, that's just saying that person having those four decrees that allows them to visit another nation state from their state or their nation. The reason why I'm asking for clarity here is because visas are issued even though you have a passport when you come to visit. So that's why I was trying to get clarity on that to make sure. Are we going to be issuing visas for temporary stays on our land, even though another person comes from another nation with their passport? That's the question.
Well, Islam, point of interest again. I'm going to ask that we table this law.
All right.
For further review. Because it's a lot that we got to understand about being abroad and, okay, could you scroll to paragraph A?
Of this section?
No, up, Irvin.
That every child?
That every child being a Morris American citizen resident abroad who desires to enjoy the protection of this government. Okay, one thing about when you leave this country to go to other countries, you really only have a certain time period to stay in that country.
Right.
And, you know, if you stay too long, you can end up becoming a citizen in that country because you've been gone too long. This is why the government only allows you a certain period of time, because by the laws of other nations and international law, if you reside in that country too long, you become a resident versus being a visitor. Okay? So this is saying that every child being a Morris American citizen, resident abroad, who desires to enjoy the protection of this government be required upon reaching the age. Something like that, I want to put more clarity into that for everybody so they can understand that even better. Because, see, that's something like that would apply to, yes, say it's an American and he went abroad and he had a wife and he got married over there to a woman and they had a child during the time frame that he was over there and they was trying to really make up their mind whether they're going to live over there or they were going to come back to America and live. That child, if they stayed there, would probably, I can't say that. See, in international law, when a man marries a woman always, her nationality becomes the nationality of the man. So if a French woman married an American man, her nationality would then become, she would become an American citizen. If a French man came to America and married an American woman, and they was going to go live back in France, she would have French citizenship, automatic, because it's her nationality going to follow her. But if he chose to live here in America, he would then become French American. I know it sounds kind of crazy a little, but this is how it works. He don't necessarily lose his nationality unless he decides to move and live here. You know, the United States is a very unique country, very unique, and I don't really think a lot of people really get the makeup of it and what it really is. You know how when we was young, we used to play the game tag, and then you had like a safe thing that like if a person ran and they touched it, then if you tagged them, they couldn't be hit because that was like the safe thing. So the United States is sort of like that. It's the safe thing. So it is the only country, and like we got a habeas corpus that we was putting together, and then it is explaining to you this is a very, very new and relative thing, United States citizenship, the way that it works. It has never been implemented in the course of history, this type of setup where citizenship can and nationality can be converted to a nationality of another state, okay? And so we got to get an understanding of that, but that's a talk for another time. But I just want to make sure that y'all kind of understand. I'm going to kind of vote to table this one for further review and bring it back at a later time, at a later date. Islam, yellow floor.
Islam, I second that, President, because it probably needs a lot more fine-tuning. But it is to be understood that, of course, by everyone, this is the very first sentence. The Secretary of State is authorized to issue, under such rules and regulations as the President shall prescribe, certificates of nativity to natural-born American nationals. That's really the only sentence that pertains to us. And then to its citizens who temporarily reside abroad, that's kind of like where the rest of it is applying to. So when we reread this law, we should keep that in mind as well. As long as we have a question on the floor by Secretary of State.
It's still going back to the last page. I just want to make sure. Now, again, amendment or just clarity. Madam Speaker, we have treaty relations with respect to rights of USAR national citizens in order to secure their rights and privileges in accordance with Constitution and laws of USAR. If we, Madam Speaker, are doing what we're supposed to and standing in honor, then the Constitution should line up with true de jure rights. And so therefore, I think that privileges should be changed. It should be liberties and rights, or I would just want to know what the cabinet members right. thought about changing privileges and just having rights or liberties and rights. Because privilege, as we all know, can be suspended. And a true government, from my understanding, if it's aligned with a true constitution, then we should have true rights and not privileges, not just mere privileges that can be overchanged, changed over by the law.
Yes, I agree. Yes, so you see, rights of USAR national slash citizens in order to secure their rights and privileges. So the rights are actually of the nationals, and the privileges are the citizens. So that's
1 inch. 1 inch.
Yes.
I really would think that we would really need to keep that as privileges. And the reason why, because every citizen they become, and you might want to change that N in national to a capital N and the C in national, where in citizen you can leave that a small C, but you need to change the N in national to a capital N. This is the distinction between citizens with a capital C and citizens with a small C. And so if you understand that, then you understand that when people come live and sojourn with us in our land, we will be determining the civil statuses of those individuals. And those individuals are being granted privileges to live here amongst God's people. Okay? So their privileges can be revoked at any time, and they can be asked to go back home. So we have to keep in mind that, you know, and on the MSPA side of the equation, it's a story where a Japanese, a Turk, an Arabian, and some other guy walked into the Moorish Science Temple of America, and the secretary asked the prophet, what kind of card do I give to these people? He said, you get on one of them cards because they become part of our adopted family. And so what she was asking was that she's telling the prophet that these people already had a nationality. So she was letting her know that they become part of our adopted family. So anyone becoming part of our adopted family, we would treat them under our constitution and laws the same as we treat our citizens. But they are not of the bloodline and of the birthright, but we will grant them certain privileges and immunities of citizenship in our country and to be able to live here in harmony with the rest of the citizens that live here. I yield the floor.
Ms. Long, Mr. President, I go ahead. We'll go ahead and vote based upon the.
He tabled it.
He tabled.
Yeah,
okay.
he tabled it for next time.
Okay, well, we'll see.
Yeah. So, all right. So, President Canabay, we're going to table this law. I second that. That we put it to vote the next time that we're here, so that everyone has a much better understanding of it and reading through it, and so that it might have the proper grammatical, the reading the next time that we actually are up for vote.
Point of interest.
President Canabay, was there anything else that you wanted to say on this one, or no?
No, I yield the floor to, I believe that's Brother Cunha. I yield the floor to him.
All right.
Yeah, when we're redoing this, can we extend to 5 years? Because, you know, a lot of us, you know, we go on vacation maybe once every two or three years, and to have to get a new passport every time we go on vacation is kind of, you know, inconvenient.
Islam, this law actually is, yes, I think that we probably need to look at that as well. So we can make our proposals and amendments when we meet next time. So everyone, please have a chance to go through it as carefully as you possibly can. I hear background noise. Please mute your phone. And so that we can make sure that we have all of the best understandings as possible for these laws. So there were only three laws today passed. We have our 011-01 to establish laws adopting a specialized land court. We have our public law 110-01 to establish laws adopting the Uniform Commercial Code as laws of USAR. And we have public law 112-01 to establish laws for notarial acts. All three of these laws have been passed today, our Continental Congress, and our posting of these laws shall be effective tomorrow in the public. President Canabe, I just wanted to, if you don't mind, before we end our meeting, well, let me just say this. If anyone has anything that they would like to bring to the floor before we end our meeting, feel free. We will give you 30 seconds to speak.
Point
Islam,
of interest.
We have Secretary. Islam, who's point? Is that Rafael?
Yeah, this is Rafael.
Okay, Rafael. Yes, go ahead, please.
Yes, no, in regards to passport, I agree with all the gentlemen that the passport should be extended to 5 or 10 years because I have been applying, and I know a lot of people that travel or have businesses also. They apply for residences in other countries, and most visas or residence permits, they're for 5 years or even 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
So when you try to apply, they need you to have a passport with, you know, 5 years. It's like me. My passport would expire on 23, and I just had to renew it to extend to 10 years because I'm getting a visa, a resident visa for 10 years. So I had to renew my passport for a 10-year passport all over again. So I think 2 years, yes, is very, very, you know, the time is very limited. And I know we're just thinking right now present, but I think about people who are in business and for the future. And that's why the United States has a 10-year passport, because they already verified and they know that other people require to stamp visas. And not unless you have like a 10-year passport, they will not put a visa sticker on it, or 5-year, or, you know, and or so on. So I think this should be reconsidered, and we should extend for more time on the passport issue, okay? You on the floor.
Thank you. Islam, there was another person who wanted to speak, I think Secretary of State, and then was there someone else? All right, let's have Secretary of State Ross. What do you think?
Islam, can brothers and sisters hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure, first of all, I want to say I want to thank all the cabinet members for coming again and participating in this historical event for our people, number one. And number two is for all our new cabinet members, you have duties that you have. So I want to make sure that you get your duties sent to you along with your law library, along with the laws that you already have and that you know and been studying and researching. So you're going to add it to your library, and you're going to continue your studies, and you're going to add on to your duties that have been given to you as a foundation. All of us that are on this line, if you do not have your law library with your duties, please let me know so that you can get that in hand, and you'll be on your way with the laws. And that's what I wanted to say to our brothers and sisters on here. I yield the floor back to the moderator.
Yes, Ramon, and thank you. Anyone else?
Islam,
you have the floor.
Islam Morris, I'd like to welcome the brothers and sisters who have recently taken their oath. Welcome to your national government. Islam.
Islam.
Islam, yes. Anyone else? I would like to bring up this point that I've brought up on the screen. And if anyone else feels that they are good in researching, I would love to see the other territory or provinces with this same information, because I think it's important. It says printed statutes of other states to be received in evidence. And this is in the Missouri revised statute. And I want to make this point. It says printed books or pamphlets purporting on their face to be the session, as Congress in session, or other statutes of any of the United States or the territories thereof, or of any foreign jurisdiction, and to have been printed and published by the authority of any such state, territory, or foreign jurisdiction, or proved to be commonly recognized in its courts, shall be received in the courts of this state as prima facie evidence of such statute. So the state of Missouri wants you to know that once you publish your laws from a foreign jurisdiction, or once you've printed them and published them, or if your court mandates it or decrees these laws, therefore, this foreign jurisdiction or that's proved to be commonly recognized in the courts shall be received in the courts of this state as prima facie evidence as statute. So as we publish our laws and we put them, if we need to, into the court of Missouri, let's say, this is what they're stating in the statute, then they will be recognized as prima facie evidence. So all we have to do is pass our laws, publish our laws, decree them as laws in our jurisdiction or in our courts. But it's an either-or situation. We publish them or our courts decree them. And I just wanted to bring that up.
Point of interest.
So if anyone has any other state province that they can find this information in, I think it's most helpful for us to understand that all we need to do is to have our courts decree it or to publish it on our website, and they will see it as prima facie evidence. And let me go ahead and yield the floor to our Secretary of State.
Islam, Madam Speaker, only thing I wanted to bring up is prima facie for the new people on the line to make sure that they have an understanding of that. Could you please explain that for them? Because, you know, you see.
So if you show it, it's going to actually show on its face. That's what it says, as evidence, unless somebody goes deeper and proves it to be evidence. So they can always go and prove it. But if it's, as long as it's published and as long as your court decrees it and they've got that evidence of it, then it will provide them as the evidence on its face. Islam. Anyone else?
President Canterbury, I just wanted to ask Brother Raphael, if you can give me a call after this. I'm trying to get this the bank information that he had left with me before.
Brother Raphael, are you there?
Yes, I am. I will contact you, Canterbury. Yes, President, I will.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. All right. And anyone? That was a point of interest?
Yes, this is Brother Rich Wilson, Bray.
Yes, Brother Rich. Let me have
I was hoping Ross Woody, Jr., Secretary of State, could give me the law library that he mentioned. I don't have that yet.
Okay. Islam, Brother Ross, he did hear you say that you needed the law library. And
okay.
Our other two new people as well. So Brother Galen and Brother William Eel.
Yes, Islam, yes. I was about to ask Secretary of State Ross for that law library myself.
Yes.
Islam, this is Sister Adjoa Bay. I would like to also put in a request for that as well.
All righty. Thank you.
One more, Islam.
Islam?
I also need that. Yes. Islam.
Clayton Henderson Eel also.
I'm also need that law library.
Is there anyone else?
One is Channing Bay. While I got y'all on the call that's here today that's attending. I wanted to say this to you. We're going to be sending out a promissory note that I really, really need everyone to sign, because I believe it's the way that we're going to fund our government. These promissory notes that we all will be signing, including myself, just so everybody knows, we're going to see if we can't deposit these promissory notes into our trust account to fund our trust, so people will be able to start getting paid for the job positions that they are in. And I went to sleep, and I woke up. This was one day last week, and it was in my head. So I talked to a couple people about it and explained it. But this is how we fund our government. Promissory notes are legal tender. We have to begin to understand what the promise is and how the promise works. Our trust is a trust created by the Honorable Prophet Noble Drew Ali, which is the trust office.
Islam, is anyone there?
Islam?
Yeah.
President, there's a couple of people who mentioned, but I wanted to just say, President Canabay, can we talk about that a little bit more before it's proposed?
Well, I'm just pulling coattails about it, just making them aware of what I'm talking about doing, so that they had a correct understanding of what we're talking about, what how it works and functions, so that they understand.
Okay. You're talking about getting people educated in this arena, just so people understand. It's not like they're going to get a promissory note, not know what to do with it. We want to have a thorough education on this topic.
I'm giving it right now. They don't need no more education. That's what I'm giving, the education right now. So if I give anybody on this phone, if I was to do a $50 million promissory note right now and give it to anybody on this phone except for Raphael, they would not know what to do with it. They would not know how to cash it. They would not know how to use it to the benefit of their purpose, period. The only way these promissory notes is not.
I apologize for the interruption.
I'm trying to explain it. I'm trying to explain it so people get the right understanding.
Yes.
I know people want to get paid for doing their job. I know they're ready for their government to start moving. I'm trying to explain it. Oh, he dropped off the phone. Nazir, I know he also understands. Governor Nazir, I know he also understands. Did somebody else have another point of interest?
There were two other people who mentioned that said Islam. Who were those two, please?
Islam.
Yes,
Islam.
Mr. Ajoabe, you were cut off in the middle of your explanation, President Canabay. I'd like to hear more of it. You just cut out, and then you all came back.
Yeah, Islam.
Okay.
Is it possible, President Canabay, that we can have a special meeting for this? Some people might, of course, with it being 4:11, we're a few minutes over our time frame to end this call. Is it possible that we could dedicate another call to this, please?
Islam.
Mr. President, I second that.
Islam.
Islam, point of interest.
Okay, we have Leslie Eckenfield, and then we have Galen Carson Day. Islam, Brother Leslie, you have the floor.
Yes, Brother President. I will get with you on Wednesday to bring you that information, and I propose that we have a special meeting Friday evening on that.
Okay.
I yield the floor.
Okay.
Islam.
Islam, and then Galen Carson Bay.
Yes, Islam. Okay, so as President C. Cannon Bay was stating, the promissory note is legal tender. So yet that would be our government, and then us becoming our own banks, or say, as you said, with the trust. So this would be more or less of the same as a money order, or if I'm not mistaken. Am I correct in my thinking? Islam, I yield.
Islam, Mobike, you got it.
Islam.
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 Islam. Islam.
My question.
Oh, go ahead.
Islam.
Go ahead, sister.
Would just like to ask, so then if they're given to us for the signature, it's so that it's goes back to the state and it's used through the state, and then we receive funds from the state, though. Is that how it works?
It's not.
It's
I said only a couple of people was going to understand. Things like all of y'all understand.
Islam.
You know, I'm going to say this without going in debt, because it seems like our Secretary of State and our Speaker of the House don't want me to go too far in debt with it, but I will say this. She played the song Nas, and Nas said, what you searching for, you the answer, you the question and the answer. We being the actual promise, the promised people who was brought to the promised land, the promised people of God. And we are that promise. And we have to understand that it's all our promise, which is our word, that we are able to create from within ourselves ability to function for ourselves. And we have to begin to really understand that, you know, in the Bible, God said each one of us is worth a price. That's not the only way that we can fund ourselves, seeing that each one of us men walking around here is worth about $29 million just the melanin in one of our bodies. We have to learn how to take our assets and include our children by creating these, the same thing that they did, creating a bond, which is also a form of creating a revenue because our children are assets. So we start really understanding these simple things. We won't be running around like chickens with our head cut off, and we can start focusing more on our government and running our government, because people are actually getting paid to do their job. And there's so many of us that's so distracted by money and the want and needs of personal wants that we can't see daylight sometimes. So, you know, the prophet said that, you know, we have a higher self and a lower self, and a lot of us haven't. We still got some things we need to conquer as far as material and understanding that you never own nothing. This is why I say never own nothing, control everything. The state is the one authoritative figure that says who owns what and has owned, so therefore all true ownership of property lies within the state. It lies within the state. Anybody on the line that got a vehicle, or somebody came and said that was their car, first thing you're going to do is go pull out your car title. Who made that up? Who named on that? The state. Same thing with a house. Same thing with your child. Same thing with anything that you're doing right now, like all your ownership rights and any type of property come from state. And so we got to get a greater understanding. And I supposed to be doing a law class on, I think, Monday nights or Tuesday nights. I think we're going to have to really get that cranked up, because the more understanding I can get to y'all, then the more doors and windows in y'all mind that will open and y'all begin to see. The picture even more clearer. And I'm really itching to get it out of me and get it to y'all and make sure that it's recorded. Because we all know that it happens. So, before it happens or anything happens at all, I want to make sure that y'all have a very good understanding of a lot of great many things. So I want to pull this water out of my pitcher. And I want people to receive this water. I know y'all thirsty. So, man, I'm ready to fill some cups. Let's do it. Islam, I give you a go.
Islam. Point of interest. Mr. President, everything that you have just said, you know, cabinet members, you know, upper branch, lower branch, I can't speak for everybody, but I can say that the Missouri province agrees with you on everything that you just spoke about. Only thing of the question of concern, I've always told you, I got your back, your side, your front, and everything. But when we talk about certain things, you know, we have to look at everything, and that is security. We still are moving forward because we're in a perpetual motion to move forward no matter what. But the bottom line is that what you're putting out, we wanted to make sure that everybody on this line is unified. That's the only biggest concern. And the other thing is security, when we're putting that out there, because you've always stressed that that was very important, considering that what it's attached to, see, you've always put that out there. So I've always kept that in the strictest of confidence. So I know you know what I'm talking about when I say that. So having said that, we just want to make sure that we dot our I's and cross our T's on this one and make sure that when we do it one time and one good time. If we have to make amendments to it, they're going to be very slight and small and minute. So that was our concern. It's not that we're not with you. It's just that we want to make sure everybody has an understanding. And I'm saying that, President, I yield the floor.
Islam, well, this is not something that's going to be voted on. Not something that will be voted on because it's dealing with legal tender. But it's something that so everybody needs to get an understanding of is that, you know, you got a lot of people running around trying to do promissory notes, trying to do this and that, and be saying, trying to do all kinds of stuff, but they fail to realize how these things actually work. None of it is really designed for the individual to be running around doing this and doing that, and you know, it's just not designed that way. You know, the greatest thing that you can do is to be a servant. The Bible tells you must go low to come out high. By you being a servant, you come out high. Because you dedicate your life to what? Public service. A lot of people don't get it. These people ain't trying to be in politics for nothing. They get it. They know. The greatest thing in the eyesight of God is to be a servant. So we got to really get a great grasp of that. You know what I'm saying? That I'm going to share something with y'all that I was telling a friend of mine just yesterday. I said, you know, I was looking into opening up like a Dunkin' Donut franchise, right, restaurant. And they came to me with the information because I had asked them to get the information from me quite a while back, like 4 or 5 months ago. And I said, I don't need that. I'm good. And they was like, you ain't going to open it now? I said, no, because I ain't going to have time. I got a franchise that I'm already running. And this franchise is called the United States of America Republic, and it's the franchise of the Moorish American people. And I'm going to have no time to be dedicating myself to governing or running or managing a restaurant franchise because we get ready to live the next century reaping. Not what I've got been. Reaping a reap. And God says it in the Bible. I didn't send y'all there to have your back bent. I sent y'all there to reap. So while everybody else is thinking about the nice kind of car they want to ride, that ain't what I'm thinking about because I know I'm going to be riding in the back of a limousine. You feel what I'm saying? I know I'm not worried about what my wife's going to cook because we're going to have a cook. We cook whatever we want. This is how we're supposed to be living, and this is what we're doing. Islam, I yield the floor.
Islam, Brother Kanabe, thank you. And so tomorrow, for those who want to join, there will be a law task force at 7 p.m. Standard Time at on Monday, tomorrow. So I will send out that information as well. Who was that with a point of interest?
Nateer Akil.
Nateer Akil, Islam.
Islam. I'd like to piggyback off, but yes, I did.
Okay.
I'd like to piggyback off what Brother Cannon Bay was just saying. I was just reading up on their public laws about the promissory notes and legal tender case law, and that's exactly what it says. It says that the state has to do those, not the individual people, and that's what people been getting messed up at, and he's absolutely right. I was just reading the case law on that.
Yes, Islam. And I'm wondering, President Kanabe, would we have to pass those laws?
Well, that's just for the state. It's not for the individual to get promissory notes. It's the state to get the promissory note, and I guess it passed the cash out to the individual.
Oh, no. I was just asking the president whether or not we would need to pass those laws as a state.
No, there's no laws that we need to pass for that.
No,
the international bill of exchanges, we would have to pass a law that I know of. But the promissory notes, we don't need to pass. That's not a law that needs to be passed. I understand that promissory notes are legal tender, just like the Federal Reserve note that you walk around with in your pocket. It's the same thing.
But
the Federal Reserve, listen to me. The Federal Reserve note that you walk around with in your pocket is a promissory note designed to pass over the counter, hand to hand, to a person in a store. Okay? If I was to go to a big furniture store in New York where a little small coffee table costs $25,000, you best believe in their finance department, they got somebody in their finance department that will accept a promissory note for that or an international bill of exchange for that.
Yeah.
Okay? As well as banks deal with promissory notes. They in their laws, they allow to deal with promissory notes. And it is legal tender to a bank. So when we really understand these things, we have to begin to understand that a promissory note that's not a Federal Reserve note, which is an obligation, but it is legal tender. The only difference is it's not legal tender that you can pass over the counter to somebody. Don't work that way. Each one of these different financial instruments have a way that they are to be used in accordance with the creation of them. So there's no writing out a promissory note for $30,000 and go get the money for it. That's not how it works. So we would not be depositing promissory notes and pulling out Federal Reserve notes. That's not how it works. And I'm gonna leave that at that.
Thank
you. Islam. Point of interest.
All right, Islam. And so, but I just want to make this point: the United Nations International Convention on Trade Laws is where we find the bill of exchange as the IBOE, as well as the promissory note. So I would just wanted to make it clear that if we're going to do one, we have to do the other, and but looking at the laws that govern that, aren't those the laws that we actually have to look to, and isn't that part of the United Nations? So that's the point I wanted to bring up. I do understand about promissory notes. I do understand about IBOs. And I will look forward to our class on this for more information. So are you saying that you would like to, on Monday night tomorrow, talk about this? Or what day?
Okay. First thing I'm going to say is I'm not going to have a class on promissory notes. What we're going to do is have people start researching and reading up on promissory notes from the UN and how they should be written, how they should look, how they should be presented as far as if it has to have some type of security code on it or whatever, which I know it don't. But I don't want to have no more classes on stuff like this. So
something like this, that law is already in circulation that people are doing every day when they buy a house or they buy property or whatever they're doing, where they sign a promise, they end up from buying a car, you sign a promise there, you know, beside that. So I want people to understand that that's not a law that has to be passed. Nobody can pass a law on your promise as a nation of people. The promise that you make as a nation of people to your children and to yourself as a nation is a promise that you got to upkeep and uphold. It's real simple. So the only thing that we would really be looking into the promissory laws for is uniformity of the presentation of our promissory notes and to keep in alignment with the rules and regulations that already circulate in circulation dealing with promissory notes. Islam,
thank you. We're going to go ahead and end this call, but was there another Islam on the floor? Someone had a point that they wanted to make.
Yeah, President Canabay, one more point. But what you should take down right now, the other point of interest from anybody else should be those who are going to start reading and studying the information so that they can come to this call and Canabay can be quiet and he can learn from them.
Islam, and okay. So anyone wanting to state that they have some experience they would like to bring to the floor on this or any research that they're going to be doing on this, I believe Canon Bay just asked for them to mention it.
Actually, the volunteer for a task force that's researching and studying promissory notes, at least three people, that will converse with one another on a constant, steady basis to gain constant overchanging of promissory notes.
Islam, Cannon Bay, this is Sister Charlene, and I'll dedicate myself to taking on that because I have been working on that actually for a while, so to get an overstanding of what I already have. Because we already have a lot of work, and I've been looking at that for over 2 years. So I will be happy to dedicate myself to that.
Islam, right. I would like thank to join you. In myself.
Okay, Brother Galen, thank you. Anyone else?
Islam, I would like to volunteer.
Rafael, Islam. Okay.
I mean, you don't have to be a rocket scientist for this, y'all. All it requires is a notebook and to be able to read and take notes to the things that jump up off the pages that you need to read. Get you a yellow highlighter and highlight the things that stand out.
Islam, Sister Ajoa.
Yes, Ajoa Bey, I would like to join in on that task.
Islam, thank you. Anyone else?
Islam, Nasir Akil.
Nasir Akil?
Yes.
All right.
I also have, I already have all the packages for the unsuitable prevention and all that. I have both of them for international law and trade. So I got a lot of research for that.
Islam. So what will do, anyone else, by the way, before I end that topic? Oh. Was that another person asking to be part of it, the research team?
Okay. Islam, this is Sister Ajua. I would like to know how we can make sure that we can get in contact with each other so that we
Yep,
we can
I was just about to say that with the recording of this call today, I will send out a new directory. So that would be the updated directory. So all of the people who have volunteered, Sister Charlene McMullen Day, for the Galen Carson Day, for the Rafael Vasquez Eel, Sister Ajoa Bay, and Brother Netra Kill, I forget your full name because I always call you Netra Kill. So if you can be responsible for contacting each other on this note, on this meeting. And what is the preferred time for you to meet? You know, you can, of course, coordinate that amongst yourselves. Unless, Cannon Bay, did you want to be involved in that conference call?
You say nope.
No, I do not. Unless right. somebody to teach me something for a change.
All right. Okay.
That's what I want. I want, hey, and we need to get another group to start studying the International Promissory Notes and Bill of Exchanges. We need somebody, another group to do that. Now, we do have information on this stuff as well, which is a book from the United Nations on promissory notes and another book and information from the United Nations about International Bill of Exchanges. And like I said, Brother Raphael, y'all probably would like to appoint him as the head of that task force for y'all because he's very knowledgeable in a great many things when it comes to finance. Islam, I yield the floor.
Did I hear that right? Excuse me.
Islam, on the
intro. I know you'd be on the plane, brother. I know you'd be on the plane. I'm just messing with you.
But
I know you can point them in the right direction to the information that they can pull off the internet to do their research and study. Islam?
Well, there's a lot of it behind the scenes because most of the stuff that you're talking now is not what you see on the books or what you hear, but at the end of the day, I have worked on this project for the past 5 years, and I am barely opening the lessons, okay? I was in Mazatlan, Mexico. It just so happened that I went all over the world, and I found some light in Mexico where I met very people knowledgeable that work with IVOs and promissory notes, okay? Believe it or not. And they're very wealthy, and I'm connected with them. I was with them last week, Monday and Tuesday, and very satisfied, so I should have updates on that, okay? So I'm working on a deal there with them for $260 million for projects in Paraguay and Argentina, and one for $10 million in Mexico, okay?
Okay.
So, we can discuss this, but it's a lot more complex than people think. If you go the right way, believe me, you're going to go through a lot of no way out, dead ends, because you know what? It's not what you see. A lot got to do with who you know and who you deal with, and it's a very close circle, okay, for very privileged people. But at this level, I think the best thing is for everybody to really, really pay attention to this because the future, your future depends on it. And there's going to be a lot of changes in the near future where we need to create currency to purchase metals because the future, you know, just shows that we're going to be dealing with gold and silver all over again. Okay? And that's where I'm concentrating on, okay? Right now I'm purchasing gold mines, silver mines, minerals, because that's basically what's going to have value, okay? And everything else is just going to flip-flop and disappear. So promissory notes and bills of exchange by international law, most people, if you have any knowledge, is really, really the only money that is backed by gold and silver in the United States. Everything else is just a promise to pay. That's all. Okay? I yield the floor.
Thank you, Islam. So we shall call this the Financial Task Force team, and is there a preference on which day that you meet? Because I'm thinking maybe Tuesday, as long as we agree right now that the day is good for Sterling, Galen, Raphael, and Ajoa, and Netzer Kill.
Islam, I'd say yes.
Islam, what would be the time of that?
I'm not involved in it, so it's up to whomever is involved. So whatever you would like.
So if I need to pronounce or present my number now, I will. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
This is probably best. I will send out the new directory, and all of you can contact each other and coordinate the time. But as long as I know it's Tuesday and there's a head person that's going to be responsible for the call, then I can share with you how to record the call and all that goes with the board that when you call in for conferences. So, okay. So whoever you all choose for the head person, they can just get in contact with me. And I'll send out the directory no later than tonight along with the recording of this call. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and end this call right now. And I appreciate everyone in attendance and your participation. And thank you for assisting and making history with regards to passing our own laws. Once again, we are the United States of America Republic, and we are in Continental Congress assembled, passing our three laws today on this November 20th, 2016. Thank you, everyone, and may Allah be with you. And we're going to go ahead and end our recording now. It is 4:37 p.m.
Security of justice. Yeah.